Carl ripping it up as usual. Done with my vlog. Good. Only one order today. Oh, the little crossy cross.
Pink heart cross necklace.
Yeah. Pretty. Nice. Sparkly action. What do you got by a shipping label?
Yep.
Gotta ship it out today. Ship it out. What are we gonna have for?
It's going to Orlando. It's going far.
This is going to Orlando?
Yeah.
What are we gonna eat?
That is your job.
I need food.
To pick a place.
Let's go get some daggone ramen. Lately, this is our favorite ramen joint, but it's all the way in the southwest side. I get tonkatsu, mild, and I'm adding the egg. We've been here in the vlog before.
I think we only showed it once.
What is it called? Ramen Kobo?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
All right, I don't want to freak you out, but there's a spider right behind your head.
That's a big spider.
I know. The mild was a little spicy.
It was. No. But it's chilly out here. It hit the spot.
We're gonna have to go back to Virginia now and try and see if we really like this one better.
I know, we just got addicted to this one.
Yeah, and I think we're gonna have to do ramen week.
Perfect weather.
Or maybe noodle week.
Noodle week.
Or what about soup week? Not in the mood for snacks, mediocre coffee tonight. So I got some Starbucks, slightly less mediocre coffee. Still mediocre. All right, I'm on the list. Let's go get in the game. Oh yeah, what day is this? Tuesday? What up is the trooper and all that shit? it's almost 11 p.m. and I am done with poker for this Tuesday. Remember when I used to say Tuesday, the worst day for poker on the strip? So tell me this, is it getting boring having me, is it getting boring with me playing the same game at the same casino every single day? I'm at Bellagio every day now, playing 2-5, quite a few sessions in a row. That's something I always wanted to avoid. I like variety. I like to move around. I mean, I guess I could move around and play 2-5 in other casinos, but I specifically choose Bellagio 2-5 at the moment because of the $500 cap. Sometimes the game is pretty good. Sometimes it's sort of like, whatever. Tonight is one of those nights as far as the game goes. Pretty quiet overall in the poker room. Being a Tuesday in the middle of the pandemic, I end up winning 106. But hey, it's a win. That's a win. So Lady Trooper and I had planned on going down to Circa at midnight because they open at 12:01 a.m. tonight, which is Wednesday morning, the 28th. And I think we decided not to go. It's just going to be a cluster, you know what? I'm sure it's a madhouse. The place is supposed to be really, really cool. I think we're going to go there tomorrow instead, like maybe tomorrow afternoon and check it out. I don't know if I'm going to play poker tomorrow or not. If I do, it'll definitely be 2-5 at Bellagio. I mean, I just had almost no hands to play tonight. I mean, it was just very... By the way, speaking of that, there must be a lot of you guys who watch this vlog, a lot of people out there, you guys must make like 200 an hour at 2-5. Am I right? There must be dozens of you who make like 200 bucks an hour at 2-5, because it doesn't matter how many sessions I win in a row, it doesn't matter how much money I win, whether it's $600 or $200, there's always something to say. There's always something. It should be obvious to most of you, but I'm gonna say it so that anybody who doesn't understand, I'm gonna say it. I played several hours of poker yesterday. I was involved in a lot of hands, a lot of pots, right? I didn't talk about a lot of hands. I showed a couple of hands to show that I was playing poker to serve the story in the video, and I talked about the hand where I had jacks. So some people seem to be concerned that I only won 184. I mean, we didn't talk about the hand where I turned the second nut flush and the lady rivered the nut flush. Of course I lost 70 more on the river. I'm not folding for 70 more dollars. So we didn't talk about that. I'm not talking about every single hand in a session of hours of poker. I guess maybe if you want every hand throughout an entire session, go play a session. It just makes no sense. This is why I don't like to talk about poker so much in the vlog, because I get frustrated, and I shouldn't get frustrated. You guys can say anything you want to say, and you can enjoy the vlogs any way you want to enjoy them, and you can comment as any way you want to comment, but when I read something stupid, I can't help but get frustrated. So my choice is to either never read the comments again or get frustrated at shit that I read that makes no sense. Or maybe I could get over that. Maybe I could like grow out of getting frustrated when I hear. But if I did that, that would be great. Then I could read Twitter without getting frustrated and read all sorts of non-factual bullshit and not get frustrated. That's an idea. Maybe I need to go to a psychiatrist. Hey, doc, how can I not be frustrated at nonsense?